गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस इज 11th क्लास बायोलॉजी, लेक्चर 3 ऑफ चैप्टर 1. टुडे यू विल लर्न अबाउट टैक्सोनॉमिक कैटेगरीज. सो व्हाट आर टैक्सोनॉमिक कैटेगरीज? एज यू नो अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन, दैट इज ग्रुपिंग ऑर्गेनिज्म इनटू कन्वीनियंट कैटेगरीज बेस्ड ऑन देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. ओके, सो दिस क्लासिफिकेशन इज नॉट अ वन स्टेप प्रोसीजर. It involves many steps. It involves hierarchy of steps. Okay, so classification involves hierarchy of steps in which each step represents a taxonomic category, or it can be called rank. So the all the steps or hierarchy of steps which are involved for the classification represent a category. Okay, or that can be called a taxonomic category or rank. All categories together constitute a taxonomic hierarchy. So all these categories which are used here for the classifications together will make a taxonomic hierarchy. Each category represents a unit of classification, you can say. A group of organisms occupying a particular category is called a taxon, or plural form it can be called a taxa. For example, class Mammalia, it can represent a taxon. Now see here, this is hierarchical order of taxonomic categories. Here you see species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom. What are all these? These are taxonomic categories. These are called taxonomic categories, and this is hierarchical order of, this is called hierarchical order of the taxonomic categories which are used for the classification. So in this hierarchical order, first we are placing species, then genus, then family, order, class, phylum and kingdom. This can be called ascending order of the taxonomic categories. Now see the difference between taxonomic category and the taxon. What is the difference? So these all are taxonomic categories, hierarchical order of the taxonomic categories. Okay, species, genus, family, order, class, phylum or division and kingdom. Okay, in case of plants, word division is used here, and in case of animals, word phylum is used here. Okay, then how it is different from taxon? Taxon is a convenient category in which any animal is placed. Okay, so a group of animal can belong to any taxon. So here you see kingdom. Like there are two kingdoms, Plantae and Animalia. Okay, so all the animals will be in Animalia kingdom. Okay, so Animalia can represent a taxon here. Likewise, Chordata is one of the phylum, and all the chordates can represent a different taxon. So you can say taxon is a convenient category in which we can place any organism. Now take one example. For example, rice, wheat, maize, all these are plants. Okay, all these plants will come under the kingdom Plantae, right? But taxon can represent these separately. Like Plantae is a kingdom, that is a taxon, and under that Plantae kingdom there are separate classes and families of plants. So in that, wheat is representing a separate taxon. Okay, wheat can also represent a taxon. Likewise, rice will also represent a taxon. Okay, are you getting this? Means plants are representing a taxon, then under the plants there are so many different plants, so each of the plant can also represent a taxon. So taxon can be at any level. Okay, it can represent any at any level of the category. Okay, likewise you can take example of animals. Like animals, if we use the word animals, that is a taxon. And under the animals, there can be dogs, cats, okay, and there can be different species of dogs. That can be Pomeranian dogs, Alsatian dogs. Okay, so all these categories are representing the taxon. Animal is a taxon, then under that dog is also a taxon, cat is also a taxon, and the species of dogs, if we take Pomeranian, if we use the word Pomeranian specifically about the dogs we are talking and we are saying Pomeranian, okay, then what will you think? What the picture will come in your mind? Pomeranian dog picture will come in your mind, okay? So that is also a taxon. So any convenient category in which you can place any organism is called taxon, and the plural form you can call a taxa. Now let's start with the hierarchical order of the categories, and in that first is species. So you can say species is a group of closely related organisms. Closely related organisms means which resemble morphologically as well as their internal structures, okay, and which are capable of interbreeding, means which can breed among themselves, okay. So interbreeding to produce fertile offspring, right? So such a group of individuals, such a group of organisms is called species, and species is the lowest category in the hierarchical order, okay. Now see here, example of species, tiger. This is common name, okay, common name that you use. So tiger is a common name. Then this tiger come under the genus Panthera, okay. Means after the species, next category in the hierarchical order is genus. So Panthera is a genus, and tigris is the species here, okay. So what is the species? This tigris, okay. Tigris means individuals which are closely related and which can interbreed among themselves, because here the Panthera genus, under this Panthera genus many other organism, many other species will also be there. For example, leopard, okay, and leopard belongs to the species Pardus, and this Pardus species is also under the genus Panthera, okay. So species represent the organisms which can interbreed among themselves naturally, okay. So this Tigris, Pardus, these are species here. Then if we say about the modern man, in we call the name, scientific name as Homo sapiens, okay. So homo word is for genus here, and sapiens is for the species. So these are examples of species: Tigris, Pardus, and sapiens. Now come to the next category, that is genus. So we can say a group of related species is called genus, and here you can see the example of genus. This is one genus, genus Solanum, and under this genus there are many different species, okay. Look here, like potato, tomato, brinjal, all these are under the same genus Solanum, okay. Potato, tomato, and brinjal, all are under the same genus, all belong to the same genus, you can say. And what is that genus? That is Solanum. Potato is called Solanum tuberosum, tomato as Solanum lycopersicum, and brinjal as Solanum melongena, right? So these are tuberosum, lycopersicum, and melongena, these are species name, and Solanum is genus name. So you need to remember these examples also, examples of genus and species. Next category, before that we will do some more examples of the genus, like genus Panthera. And in this Panthera genus, lion, tiger, and leopard, all these are under the same genus Panthera. Like lion will be called Panthera leo, leopard as Panthera pardus, and tiger as Panthera tigris. So tigris, pardus, leo, all these are species. These are different species but are under the same genus, that is Panthera. Likewise, genus Felis. Felis include two types of cats here, jungle cat and house cat. Okay, so Felis domesticus, that is scientific name for house cat, and jungle cat, that is a different type of cat, so that also come under the same genus, that is Felis, and the scientific name for that is Felis coarse. So coarse and domesticus, these are species name here, and both these are under the genus Felis. Now next category is family. So we can say a group of related genus, or you can say genera. Genera word can also be used for the genus. So a group of related genus is called family, and here you see the example of one family, that is Solanaceae. And you have seen the example of a genus Solanum. Okay, so that Solanum genus along with the Petunia and Datura, these are also genus. Okay, Petunia genus and Datura genus. Okay, so all these genus come under the family Solanaceae. So we can say these three genus, Solanum, Petunia, Datura, all these genus come under the same family, that is Solanaceae. So we can say a group of genus is called family, right? Now we can say that a family is characterized on the basis of both vegetative and reproductive features of the plants. In the case of plants, if we categorize, say that all these plants belong to the same family, then we characterize them on the basis of both vegetative as well as reproductive features. Now there is one more example of family, that is family Felidae. Okay, so Felidae family has two genus, that is Panthera and Felis. As you know, under the Panthera genus there are lion, tiger. Okay, and under the Felis genus there are cats. So both these genus come under the same family, and what is that family? That is Felidae. Next category is order. Order is assemblage of families which exhibit a few similar characteristics, right? So as we go higher in the hierarchical order, that similarities becomes less among the organisms. So here we say that order includes the families. Order includes many families which have some similarities among themselves. Okay, so these are these similarities are less than the similarities which are found among the members of species, or among the members of genus, or among the members of families. These similarities are less than those similarities, but still they have few similar characteristics. Okay, so you can say assemblies of families is called order. And here there is one example of order, that is Polymoniales. Okay, Polymoniales, and this order included two families. First is Convolvulaceae, and second family is Solanaceae. So Convolvulaceae is a family which includes many plants, and also Solanaceae is a family. So both these families come under the same order, Polymoniales. Then next is order Carnivora. This is another example of one order. So Carnivora is the order which included family Felidae along with the family Canidae. Okay, so in the Canidae family, dogs are there. So we can say dogs also come under the order Carnivora along with the tigers, lion and cat, because all these belong to the family Felidae, and dogs belong to the family Canidae. So all these belong to the same order. And what is that order? That is Carnivora. Remaining taxonomic categories we will do in next lecture tomorrow. And based on today's topic, your homework is NCERT question number 6, 7 and 8. Now we will discuss the homework solutions of previous lecture. So I gave question number 1 to 5 of NCERT as homework. So let's discuss the answer of question number 1 first. Why are living organisms classified? So the answer is, a large variety of plants, animals and microbes are found on the earth. All these living organisms differ in size, shape, color, habitat, and many other characteristics, right? As there are millions of living organisms on the earth, studying each of them is impossible. As you know about the biodiversity, the types of organisms present on the earth, how many species are present on the earth? 1.7 million to 1.8 million. So can you think to study such a huge number of organisms or such a huge number of species is possible separately if we want to study these species? It is not possible. Therefore, scientists have devised mechanisms to classify all living organisms, and this classification system also helps in making study of organisms easy and organized. Second question are, why are classification systems changing every now and then? The classification system means the criteria on the basis of which we classify the organisms is changing. Why? So answer is, millions of plants, animals and microorganisms are found on earth. Okay, many of these have been identified by the scientists, while many new species are still being discovered around the world. Okay, still many new species are being discovered. Therefore, to classify these new discovered species, new system of classification have to be devised every now and then. This creates the requirement to change the existing system of classification. As we discover the new species, so to classify those new species, new system of classification is also required. What different criteria would you choose to classify people that you meet often? So answer, you will you can classify the people on the basis of some criteria, like the first of all you will see for the place where they live, right? Then you will see the gender, like anybody is male or female. On the basis of that, you can put those people into separate categories. Then their names will be there to classify those people. Then their way of talking will be there to classify those people. And from your side, you can choose any criteria to classify the people that you meet often, right? So these are some criteria. Then question number 4 of NCERT that was given. And the question was, what do we learn from identification of individuals and population? So the knowledge of characteristics of an individual or its entire population help in the identification of similarities and dissimilarities among the individuals of same kind or between different types of organisms. It helps the scientists to classify the organism into various categories. Question number 5 was, these two scientific names are given for mango, and you need to tell that which one is correct. So see here, in the first one, this is Mangifera indica. As you know, according to the nomenclature rule, that genus names first letter comes capital and the species name first letter should be small. But here in the indica, this I is capital. That's why this is wrong. The second one, this one is right. Genus name is in capital M and the species name, that is indica. So I is small here. That's why this is this name is correct. Okay, and both these are written in italics, so there is no problem.